one of the initiatives that we thought about early doors on the project was how we were going to keep traffic off the A96, which is just over there, being a very busy trunk road on the main route between Elgin and Aberdeen. And we thought about, well, we could build a temporary haul road, and that's what we ended up doing. This road that we're standing on at the moment is built this to prevent build-up of lorries and site vehicles going up and down the A96. As it turns out, this road, we're going to lift it and put it back to grass. But since then, the council have come up with a scheme that they're trying to encourage more people on their bikes, cycling, and the new cycleway we're going to build through Elgin. They're going to actually utilise this part of the haul road as part of the cycleway. So it's a win-win situation. We don't have to take away the material, and it's going to be left here for a good purpose. So the road's just about, there's not an awful lot of work needing done to it other than some timber edging and redressed, but it's basically here.
Prior to actually commencing on site, we'll put together an environmental management plan. As part of that environmental management plan, we will set up a site compound plan that will include fuel storage areas, waste segregation areas, spill kit locations, any stockpiles that we may have, anything really that's pertinent to the environment, so it could be tree protection areas. Everything will be identified. The like of material storage areas will always be away from traffic routes to prevent damage and maybe covered in order to prevent any weather penetration.
At the start of the project, we looked to set out a compound plan such as this, which will detail the areas, and basically is trying to get a strategy for the optimal location for each of these areas. So as you can see here, the skip area will be kept away from other areas of the site. The concrete washout area will be up here, and again, that's so that the security is able to direct the drivers to that particular location.
What we have is this drawn sent to all the contractors. It's displayed off site. It lets the contractors know how they enter the site. Again, it's the shortest route in for them. It's the delivery route, which is the least nuisance to the hospital, which is operational at all times. Again, our office. We drive up to site entrance. As seen, we have the lorry set down area and the waste storage area. We then have a one-way system to the site, running through to the site exit. They are not allowed to go into the hospital grounds, they have to turn left and go onto the main road and exit the whole hospital footprint. We have to avoid at all times the main hospital entrance routes, as it goes to the ID departments, and that's the ambulance routes which we have to avoid.
We use a piece of software called Masternaut Greener Fleet software. It allows us to actually calculate the miles of each journey that's undertaken within a Graham van. We can then equate this to the CO2 that has been emitted on that journey based on the driver's style, idling time, and the specific emissions associated with that vehicle. So this software actually helps us to compile a green score for each journey that we are undertaking within those fleet vehicles.